Welcome to the Best Coast Shire Council Report, your weekly update on council news and events.
Hi, I'm Simone Short.
And I'm Steve Fury.
And welcome to this week's show. A little later on, we'll be joined by Council's Chief Executive Officer, Paul Buckley, to talk about the budget. But first, the latest round of community grants were awarded and there was a lot of support for women in sport.
That's right, Simone. Of the 36 successful grant recipients in round one, there were 10 sport and recreation grants. And one of these was for the Bass Valley stand-up paddleboarding mums and ladies who were granted $2,187 to establish stand-up paddleboarding at Coronet Bay. The idea started from the Come and Try days they ran with Inverloch's Swell Mamas, who auspiced this group, and the sister surfing partnership model means that everyone gets a turn as a tag team between surfing and minding kids on the beach.
Another grant recipient was the Phillip Island Football Club, who received $1,065 to help start an under-18s youth girls team. Now, this is great for the area, and with the 8 teams in the new AFL women's competition, we're pretty sure it won't be long before we see some local players competing at that level too.
I bet we will. Overall, round one grants totaled $63,570, and if your group or organisation hasn't applied yet, don't worry. Round two applications are going to open on the 12th of August. For more information, visit basscoast.vic.gov.au/grants. Joining me now is Council's Chief Executive Officer, Paul Buckley. Welcome, Paul.
Thanks, Steve. Good to be here.
Paul, it's one of the biggest items that Council looks at every year, and it gets the most amount of scrutiny, and rightly so. I'm talking about Council's budget, of course, which was passed at the June Council meeting. Now, this budget is different from those that we've previously adopted. What makes this one different?
Well, this one includes the state government imposed rate cap of 2.5%, and we got very strong community views about council making sure that it does apply that 2.5% cap. So we had to review our long-term financial plan to incorporate that, but we've certainly done that, and it's a new constraint, and it certainly forced us to take a look at the long-term financial plan and to make some adjustments.
Now, they say necessity is the mother of innovation, and I know that we've all been trying to find efficiencies. One example in our communications team is how we're moving the Coastal newsletter to a mainly electronic format. Now, what impact has this belt tightening had over?
Well, we've had to actually keep our operating costs at the same level as last year. So that's a nil increase from the 15-16 budget for operations. Despite this, we're still going to deliver the same range of council services and support to community assets, and we're spending about $76 million. It's important to note too that we're really refocusing our finances from the delivery of day-to-day programs and services to invest in the future of the municipality through our capital works program.
Yep, and I know there's always a heavy capital works program to try and catch up with the needs of our ageing buildings and roads. It's the asset renewal gap. So what's in the budget to try and close it?
Yeah, look, there's about $16 million in this year's capital program, predominantly making sure that we look after our existing assets. So that's what we call capital renewal. But we've also got some new projects like the Bass Valley Children's Centre. We've got the final funding allocation towards that and construction will commence shortly. We've got the Cows Revitalisation Project, which is subject to both state and federal government funding, but the council has committed some $5.5 million of its own money to that project. And we've got the upgrade of the Wonthaggi Netball Courts in partnership with the club itself and with the state government, similarly with lighting at Inverloch's Thompson Reserve. And we'll finish off the bike path from Potters Hill to Backbeach Road in San Remo, which will give us a full connection from Wonthaggi to Cows. As well as those new assets that I've mentioned, I also mentioned that 100% of our renewal target. So that is really making sure for, you know, only in the last couple of years have we been able to allocate sufficient funding to look after our existing asset base and make sure that that does not deteriorate.
That's terrific. So we did a fair amount of consultation around rate capping, which we've also mentioned previously on the show. There were Q&A sessions in Cowes and Wonthaggi, and then we even ran a live session on Facebook, which is our first attempt at something like that, and it certainly won't be our last.
No, we tried to broaden, I guess, the opportunity for people to participate in the development of the budget process and in relation to having conversations around rate capping and the long-term financial plan. We've had, you know, finance officers available and we've asked for public submissions through the budget process, et cetera, and we've had a good response.
Yeah, how many submissions did we receive on the draft budget?
We got a total of 349. However, 343 of those came from the Inverloch 3996 website, specifically in relation to a further expansion of the surf parade path. The other submitters were across a range of different issues, I guess, and projects, including a request for support of the new Cape Patterson Surf Lifesaving Facility, and we'll be working with that group to see how we can support them. Three of the submitters chose to come and talk to councillors, and we had that session on the 8th of June.
So these were some of the changes that were included in the budget before it was adopted?
That's right, and we want to make sure that we're still a low-rating, low-spending council, particularly in operations, and constantly review our processes to find further efficiencies. So we've taken a responsible approach in planning for the long-term impacts of rate capping, and when you compare us with similar councils, councils. We're actually in a pretty good position.
So if you'd like more information on the 2016-17 council budget, you can download a copy from basscoast.vic.gov.au/budget, or you can pick up a copy from any of our customer service centres, or just give us a call and we'll post one out to you. Thanks so much for joining us this week, Paul.
No problem, Steve. My pleasure.
No worries. And just before we go, a quick reminder about the Bass Coast Business Awards. Enter your business or vote for your favourite business in the People's Choice Award. Entries close this Monday, the 11th of July, so please visit basscoast.vic.gov.au/business awards to throw your hat in the ring. We've also got workshops about hooded plovers, Mars Landing, boat ramp and the Inverloch Transfer Station coming up, so please check our website basscoastvic.gov.au for more details. And that's it for this week, but as always, if you have any questions or need more information about anything we've mentioned, give us a call on 1300 BCOAST, that's 1300 226 278, or 03 5671 2211. You can also keep up to date on facebook.com/basscoastshire, or follow us on Twitter at our handle at Bass Coast. Catch you next week for more council news.
The Bass Coast Shire Council Report is broadcast on Tuesday mornings at 9:30, Thursday afternoons at 4:30, and on Saturday mornings at 10 on your community station 3MFM. Audio and transcript is also available from our website, basscoast.vic.gov.au.